Good morning. In the last video, we had seen hierarchical clustering methods, mainly agglomerative and divisive analysis methods. In this video, we will do one problem based on agglomerative hierarchical method. So, what was agglomerative hierarchical method? Where we are, it is a bottom-up approach, right? In that we are taking each data point and we are checking the similarity between the data points, and in each level we are making one clusters, and finally in the top level or in the root top level we will get one complete cluster. So here it is given one example. Discuss the agglomerative algorithm using the following data and plot a dendrogram using link approach. So this is the data that is given, and now we need to solve it using agglomerative algorithm method. And now the steps are: find the minimum distance from the matrix, then draw the dendrogram by considering data items having minimum distance and merge them into form a cluster and form a new distance matrix. So the question, it is given, we are having these many points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points are there, right? And this is the distance matrix actually. That means distance between each points. For example, E to E, it is 0, E to A distance is 1, E to C distance is 2, E to B distance is 2, E to D distance is 3, like that. This is the distance matrix. In question, it is given the distance matrix between the points. Now, we need to calculate which points are close to form the clusters, initial clusters. Now, to calculate the distance, according to hierarchical clustering method, we can use a different different distance measures, like average. We can make use of average distance, mean distance, medoid distance, simply the nearest points distance, etc. So here we are considering the single link approach. In single link approach, from one cluster to another cluster, which is the nearest points, that distance we are considering, and we are taking whether it is similar or dissimilar. So we will look into the solution. So in this first step, we are going to consider which is the smallest distance points. So when we look into the here, we can see that among with this distance matrix, we can see that E and A is the having the distance 1. Similarly, B and C is also having distance 1. That is the smallest distance between the points in the given matrix. So E and E, we can consider any one first. E and A is distance 1. Similarly, B and C is also distance 1. So we can take any one point at a time. So I can take in the first step, we can identify that E and A is having distance 1. So I can take those two points and I can make a cluster of E and A, because E and A distance is smaller. So we can consider, we are considering like it is the similar points, similarity is more. So we will group it and make one cluster. So E and A is now our distance matrix is going to change, because we combined E and A, right? The remaining point C, B, D. So we'll calculate the next smallest distance. So E and A, from E and A we can calculate the distance from C. How to calculate the distance from C? So I can take the distance between E, C and AC, and which is minimum, that I can take. So distance between E and C, from the question it is 2. Similarly, distance between A and C is also 2. So the minimum distance is 2 itself, so that the distance between E and C is 2. Now take the other one, that is B. What is the distance between EA and B? So for that I have to take what is the distance between E and B, and A and B. The distance between E and B is 2. The distance between A and B is 5. So which is the smallest distance? 2. So we'll update, that is 2. Now already we know that B and C it is one. So we updated the distance metrics based on the new cluster. The new cluster is E and A. So we combined those two and we made it as one cluster. Now instead of taking it as EC and AC distance, we need to find out whether EC is smaller or AC is smaller. Whichever it is smaller, that will be updated. Similarly, whether EB is smaller or AB is smaller, whichever it is smaller, that will be updated. Now, in this distance matrix, we know that the smallest, next smallest distance is this one. That is distance between B and C. So we can combine B and C. We can merge B and C and we can make a single cluster. So now in the first step, we got one cluster E and A. In the second step, we got another cluster, that is B and C. Now again, our distance matrix will be updated. So distance between E and A and B and C. So how to calculate is whichever it is giving the minimum distance. Whether EB is minimum or whether EC is minimum or whether AB is minimum or whether AC is minimum, whichever it is minimum, that will be taken. Similarly, if I'm calculating the distance between BC and D, you can see here. This is the first one, distance between EA and BC. So we'll check the minimum distance EB, EC, AB, AC, whichever it is minimum, that will be updated. Now if I'm taking BC and D, right? So what is the distance between BD and what is the distance between CD? Whichever it is minimum, that will be updated here. Now in this distance matrix, we can see that which is this next smallest distance, that is 2. So this we are going to consider BC and EA. So what is happening is now in the next step, these two clusters, that is EA and BC, is having smallest distance. So we will combine those two, right? EA cluster and BC cluster, and we will make the next cluster, that is EA BC. We'll make this particular cluster, that is EA BC. Now next, what is the distance between EA, BC and D? So how to calculate the distance? We'll take which is smaller, whether ED is smaller or AD or BD or CD, whichever it is smaller, that will be updated. Finally, we can combine. This is the next smallest distance. So we can combine EA, BC and D to get the final cluster. So how will our dendrogram looks like in this way? So first we combined EA, right? That will get one cluster. Next we'll combine, in the next step we combined BC, that will be given the next cluster, right? And the final cluster we will combine D. So we'll get the first cluster EA, then BC, then we will get one cluster as EABC, then the final cluster as EABCD. So this is the procedure what we are following in the case of agglomerative hierarchical clustering method. So here how we calculated the similarity between the two points using the distance measure, that also we took single link approach, right? So instead of using single link approach, we can make use of average distance, or we can make use of mean distance, or we can make use of which is the farther distance. Instead of the minimum distance, we can make use of maximum distance. So in different ways we can construct the dendrograms. Now we'll see the remaining topics in the hierarchical clustering methods. So in the last video we stopped like the weaknesses of agglomerative clustering and all, and we are introduced two more new hierarchical clustering method along with distance based methods, that is Birch and Chameleon. Okay, so Birch uses a CF tree and incrementally adjust the quality of subclusters. Chameleon, it's a high gain hierarchical clustering using dynamic model. So we will look more into these two techniques. So first one is Birch. Birch stands for Balanced Iterative Reducing and Clustering Using Hierarchies. So here what we are using is, we are using distance measures also. As we told in the previous one, we are making use of distance based clustering also. We are making use of hierarchical clustering also. So here what we are doing is, we are constructing a clustering feature. We had seen that in the case of Diana or in the case of agglomerative clustering and all, we had seen that each cluster, each level, we are making one cluster, and that cluster is represented by the data points as it is. For example, A and B is combined, that particular cluster is represented by A comma B. In the Birch method, instead of representing it as a data point, each level it is representing as a clustering feature. And like that, each level we'll have a set of clustering features, and those clustering features will give you a clustering feature tree. Okay, so incrementally construct a clustering feature tree, a hierarchical data structure for multiple cluster. So there are two phases in Birch method. Phase one is, we'll scan the database to build an initial in-memory CF tree. So a multi-level compression of data that tries to preserve the inherent clustering structure of the data. So initially we will scan the database and initial CF tree will be generated. Now in the phase two, use an arbitrary clustering algorithm to cluster the leaf nodes of the CF tree. So initially what we told is, we'll make a CF tree. After making a CF tree, then we can make use of any other clustering method in each level of the CF tree. So it's finds a good clustering with a single scan and improves the quality with a few additional scans. So single scan itself, we'll get a good quality clusters. So the weakness of this method is, it handles only numeric data and sensitive to the order of the data record also. And it is only numeric data we can handle. Now we will look into what is this clustering feature and what is that clustering feature tree. So each clustering feature is represented with three attributes, N, LS and SS. So each clustering feature is represented with three attributes, N, LS and SS, where N is the number of data points. Okay, how many data points are there in that particular level? And LS is the linear sum of N points, sum of the all points. Then SS is the square sum of N points, sum of the squares of the points. Now we'll linear sum is represented by sigma e is equal to 1 to n xi. SS is represented by sigma e is equal to 1 to n xi whole square. Now we'll see how to represent a CF. You can see in the diagram like this. This is representing a particular cluster, and this particular cluster, instead of representing with the points, for example, instead of representing like A comma B, C, D, F, etc., instead of representing like that, in the Birch method, we are going to represent it with a clustering feature. So as I told, a clustering feature is having three parameters: number of clusters, linear sum and square sum. So here number of clusters are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is represented by 5. Now each point, for example, this point is representing 3, 4. Second point is representing 2, 6. This point is 4, 5. And this point is 4, 7. And this point is 3, 8. So we'll take the sum. LS is the linear sum. So we'll add the x coordinate 3 + 2 + 4 + 4 + 3 = 16. Now 4 + 6 + 5 + 7 + 8 = 30. So linear sum is represented of these total 5 points is 16, 30. Now we'll take the square sum, that is 3 square + 2 square + 4 square + 4 square + 3 square, 54. Similarly, this y coordinate square, 190. So this is representing the square sum. So this is actually a CF, a clustering feature, right? Now again, for this particular cluster, set of clusters, we'll have another clustering feature. Now all these clustering features will be representing as a clustering feature tree. So the nodes in a clustering feature trees will be these clusters features. So we'll see CF tree in Birch. So what is that clustering feature is? It is actually a summary of this particular cluster, right? It is giving a summary of this particular cluster. So summary of the statistics for a given subcluster, that is zeroth, first, second moments of the subcluster from a statistical point of view. So it registers the crucial measurements for computing clusters and utilizes storage efficiency also. Now, a CF tree is a height balanced tree that stores the clustering features for a hierarchical clustering. So a non-leaf node in a tree has a descendants or a children. The non-leaf node stores some of the CFs of their children. Again, a CF tree has two parameters, branching factor, that is maximum number of children, and threshold, that is maximum diameter of a subcluster stored at the leaf nodes. So we look into an example of the CF tree. So we told that CF tree will have two factors, that is branching factor, how many maximum number of children, and one is a threshold, maximum diameter of a subcluster stored at the leaf nodes. So this is an example of a tree structure, right? So here you can see this is the root node. So each root node will have a clustering features like CF1, CF2, CF3, like that. For example, 6. 6, it is given maximum, it is given B as 7 and L as 6, right? Now, so each clustering feature will have, right, what it is having, it will have the how many number of clusters, cluster points are there in that particular cluster, and what are the points, linear sum, and what are the square sum of those points. So this actually representing a particular cluster. Now again, what will be the non-leaf nodes? The non-leaf nodes will be representing the what is the CF1 is representing. What is the CF1? CF1, again I can decompose that into many clusters, right? And again I can decompose that into many clusters. For example, CF1 will have again 5 more clusters. So for that, each cluster, again we can represent it with a clustering feature. Similarly, this will be decomposed until you will get the last leaf nodes. Again, for example, in this step, CF1, that is child 1 of this particular non-leaf node, that is again will have some, for example, again will have some 6 clusters. So in this way, each one is represented in the case of CF tree. Okay. Now we will move into the next one, that is chameleon method. Chameleon is hierarchical clustering using dynamic modeling. So we'll see how chameleon is working. So it is it measures the similarity based on a dynamic model. So two clusters are merged only if the interconnectivity, or we can call it as the closeness between the two clusters, are high relative to the internal interconnectivity of the clusters and closeness of items within the cluster. So based on the interconnectivity or the closeness between the two clusters, we are going to make the cluster in the next level. So actually chameleon is making use of graphs. It's a graph based and two phase algorithm. So use a graph partitioning algorithm. It uses a class partitioning algorithm. So which cluster objects into a large number of relatively small subclusters, then use an agglomerative hierarchical clustering algorithm to find the genuine clusters by repeatedly combining the subclusters. So as I told, chameleon will have two steps. One is it uses a graph partitioning algorithm. Second one, using any of the agglomerative hierarchical clustering algorithm, it will do further clusters. So this is the example of a chameleon. So how it is working is, suppose we are having a data. This is our data set, right? So we will construct, first we will construct a graph based on the distance between the points. For example, these two points is the distance, these two points is the distance. So based on the distance measures, we'll first construct a graph. So edges will be representing the distance between those two points, and nodes will be the points, the data points. Now what Chameleon is using? Chameleon can use any of the graph partitioning algorithm. Using any of the graph partitioning algorithm, it will generate the different small graphs. For example, if I'm taking these two, right, these three points are close, so I can partition that, right? So again, this is a subgraph, right? I can partition that one. This is another subgraph. This is another subgraph. Here it is another subgraph. Like that, we'll partition the graph. Then after partitioning the graph, right, we are going to merge the graph. So if we are going to merge means if P and Q are connected, if Q is among the top K closeness of the neighbors of P, right? So based on the, again, based on the neighbors of that particular K nearest neighbors we are using. K nearest neighbor method we are using. Again, whether to make it as a merge. So we can see that if I'm taking this particular graph, right, I will see that whether this graph is close to, based on the neighbors, whether this graph is close to this one or close to this one or close to this one. So whichever is applicable, that will be combined. So each one is combined in that way, and we'll get the final connectivity. Okay, so first we are having the graph. We are making use of partitioning the graph using any algorithm. Now after applying that one, we can make use of any agglomerative methods, right? We can make use of agglomerative method, that is hierarchical clustering method, that will check the closeness between the each clusters. For example, if I'm taking these two clusters, whether these two are close or these two are close, that is checking and finally making one level of clusters. That is overall framework of Chameleon. Thank you.